Hey guys, this is Savannah from Savannah's Clay Creations, and I am going to be your Sunday person for your tutorial for TC Collab. So I'm going to be showing you guys how to make this little adorable purple gumdrop. So I know it probably looks blue to you, but it actually is purple. So yeah, the color of clay it's plum from Fimo, so it's a Fimo clay. So you're just going to need a small amount of whatever color clay you want your gumdrop to be. You're going to want an eye pin or a head pin. And then you're just going to want three colors of paint, so some black, some white, and some pink. And then just something to put your face on with, so I have like a head pin and a ball tool here. So let's just get started. So you're just going to take your ball of clay, and you're just going to roll it into kind of like a cone shape like this. You want the bottom half to be smaller than the top half. Just gonna kind of do this until you get the gumdrop shape. So again, really, really, really simple right here. It's extremely, extremely, extremely simple to do. So see, I already have the shape for it. Adjust this however you need. Sorry, hopefully you guys can see this. So adjust it however you need. And then you're gonna insert your eye pin. Wherever I put my eye pin, there it is. So I'm going to make sure that this will fit, which it kind of looks like it's going to poke out, so I'm going to cut off a little bit with my wire cutters. So it's also a good idea to have wire cutters if you think your eye pin might come out the bottom. Wire cutters are really good to have. So there's your shape for your gumdrop. Fix however you need, and then you would like, the next thing you really want to do is bake it. A lot of people prefer baking it before they put the face on, but actually, it never seems to hurt my oven or my clay charms just to put the face on first. So, yeah. It also saves time if you're glazing, because if you're glazing something, then you have to wait for the paint to dry before you can glaze it, and then if you do it too early, you can ruin the entire face. But also, there's a problem with doing it this way. It's harder to get off with makeup remover if you don't, if you do it when the clay's still soft, so just took my my head pin. I'm just putting some black paint on for the eyes. So it's eye number one. Eye number two. There we go. So there's the eyes. Also have something to clean off your tools with. Now I'm gonna take my ball tool and I'm going to put the smile on. So you can do it like that, if you really want, or like I like to do it like this. There we go. So that's pretty much the face, but then you can add like little white dots like this to the eyes, make it look cuter, little cheeks. So then you just bake it at 250 degrees for this project. I would say for about 15 to 20 minutes, depending on if you want it really, really, really firm or if you want it not as firm. Like sometimes, believe it or not, I like my clay charms when they're not as firm, because sometimes they're easier to work with, and if you're going to put a face on it, then I would recommend baking it for 15 minutes and then putting the face on and then baking it for about another 3 minutes. I do it that way sometimes because it will ensure that the paint is dry, so that when you glaze it, you're not gonna mess up the face. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. So this is just a simple gumdrop tutorial, and I hope you guys enjoyed this collab. Please go subscribe to my channel and all the other collabs, all the other people in this collab channel. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, everybody. Bye.